to be honest, friends, it's a bit overwhelming how many colony sim and management games are constantly on the horizon. From cozy and casual ones to brutal and bloody ones, it's an oversaturated market and it's becoming harder to identify what's different about each one, except slight visual changes. I will say that while Folklands is yet another colony sim on the horizon, I enjoyed my time with it for a few reasons. So often, these world-building sims have us either high-paced, constantly placing down buildings and gaining new features before we can breathe and learn what the last one did, or they're more brutal towards the start and half your settlement is dead by the end of month one. It genuinely doesn't feel like there's a good balance in most base versions of these style of games, and I end up tweaking settings here and there to perfect my experience. But Folklands was the first experience that almost felt too slow. But by the end of the demo, I genuinely enjoyed the pace the game had me playing at. I could clearly see the buildings coming with further expansions of my town through the progression bar, and as each tier got unlocked, it was obvious that previous buildings would continue to be useful, and we'd be able to further refine our production process to craft new things, unlock more trades, and sell a growing variety of items at the market. There's one mechanic in this game that stood out to me, and it was the fact that some of the buildings could be placed over the top of roads and on the corners of them. No more did I have to play Tetris with new buildings, hoping my prior setup wasn't suddenly a huge mistake due to unlocking some new production facility that needed to be right next door. Not every building has the option, but enough did that I found enjoyment placing new things in previous neighborhoods that I thought previously inaccessible. Let this show that one small quality of life feature can vastly improve a player's experience. I also need to compliment the ease of the UI in this game, especially for an indie. The more I played, the more I appreciated the simplicity that I could access a large part of my town's management from as few menus as possible. Their aligning of the settlement menus really made the experience all the more enjoyable. So kudos for that. I'm not sure what the final price of this game is going to be, and how long it will take to reach the final tier that wasn't accessible in the demo, so I can't make a fair assumption of if the game will be worth it or not, particularly if you have a huge array of colony sims already in your inventory. But I can say that I enjoyed what time I spent with it, and if you're curious, feel free to stick around and check out the gameplay. Please note that this is still pre-release footage, and everything is subject to change. So don't make any final decisions based on that. Also, make sure you hit the subscribe button before you go to constantly learn about new games and support us as creators. With that, I'll say thanks for watching and see you in our next video.
Hey, how's it going then? Good day to you. Anything I can do for you? Thank you.
A good day, is it?
A good day, is it?
Hey, how's it going then?
Welcome. What can I get for you?
Hey, how's it going then?
Good day, is it? A good day, is it?
Hello, are you looking for something specific?
Thank you. A good day, is it? Hello, are you looking for something specific? Thank you.
Hey, how's it going then?
fine day for a walk, isn't it?